You know, everybody wants to think big, but you're gonna question you all day long why you exist, which job is applicable to your knowledge. Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, I am Anna, author of the website Russian Vagabond, all about life in Germany. Today I want to talk about studying in Germany, most useless degrees in Germany. Studying in Germany is great, Germany is great, economy is great, but you can study something which will never bring you money. Because you can study something for years, for 3 years, for 6 years, and in the end you will struggle to find a job. Your job would be low paid, and I think you would not happy with this, right? So why not pick up the right major and avoid the bad ones? Today I want to talk about these bad degrees, majors in Germany and German universities, which you should avoid if you don't want to have troubles in the future. You can often hear from Germans that they struggle to find a job. That's true, like some Germans struggle to find a job because they have some education which is not needed, which is not demanded in German economy, and so they can't find a job, and you as a foreigner studying in Germany, you have even lower chances. So that's why it's important to pick the right major, right university, so you will have a secure job in Germany and not having troubles, you know, like it's really pity. In general, humanities, it's the worst degrees to study in Germany because there are a lot of humanities degrees, but they all very generalized and they don't really teach you, they don't really specialize you for some particular profession. For example, you study history. By studying history, you will understand history, you will know your past, but what is like job opportunities for after study history? It's very unparticular, it's very undefined, and there are no particular job which will cover your knowledge. Like you can probably work in some museum or like a guide, a tour guide, but what else? In this video, I will talk about all useless degrees in Germany, but many, many of them humanities, because Germany has 6,000 humanities degrees. Imagine, you can study wherever you want. There are so many different humanities majors. They are not all great. Most of them actually not, and you should really avoid them. As I mentioned, history, it's a very common subject to study, but again, where you can work. Germany has some historical sites, yes, there are a few, but the jobs availability is very small, and there are not much companies or places to work with a historical background. So the next one is theology. So theology, it's religion, and you should work in a church. To work in a church, you will need to become a pastor, and to become a pastor also takes time and effort. And as you can count, one city has maybe one, two, several churches, and in one church is one pastor. And imagine how much job availabilities will you have with all other theologists graduated from German universities. Also, while studying theology, you need to learn three different languages like Greek, Latin, and Hebrew. Do you need these languages nowadays? Like, do you need Hebrew, Latin nowadays? I don't think so. So you are basically spending all these years to university studying something which is not actually needed nowadays, and which you what you probably would not use even in today's society. If you really have passion for religions, of course, go for it, but if not, you should avoid this. The next one is philosophy. In philosophy, you learn the thinking about the life, the thinking about our existence. You question a lot, but what you're gonna do is that you're gonna question you all day long why you exist, which job is applicable to your knowledge. That's the problem with humanities, because imagine how you apply the knowledge you get at university. What are you gonna do with this? Philosophy, it's very tricky subject. It gives you a lot of course, benefits, because you explore your mind, you start to think big. You know, everybody wants to think big, but which profession need you to think so big, and what are you gonna do with this? You need some additional skills. If you're ready to have additional skills, to acquire additional skills, maybe you can study this, but if not, it's a poor philosophy. Unless you work at university, it's hard to work anywhere. Maybe research and really working as a professor at university, it's the only ways. The next is linguistic and German studies. In Germany, you can study German studies, English studies, American studies, basically many, many different languages. You can study them as your major. But again, you will work with the languages, so you will either work as a translator, as a as maybe some teacher, maybe you can also do the private practice, private teaching. Also, it's very, very competitive field. There are a lot of people studying these fields, languages, and again, it's really low paid, because usually you will end up working in some kind of course where you will teach the students, you know, maybe in some private language school with a small money again. And if you're lucky, you will become a really good translator, maybe even in politics or in a high level. But again, the chances are pretty much low, and high competition is waiting for you. The next one is literature. Like, during your studies, you read a lot, obviously. You know writers, you know books, literature, maybe even international literature, not only German one. So after you can work in library, what else? Like, you can write books. What else? Like, when you just think about this, what else can I do with literature? Not much. Many people with a literature degree working in publishing houses and in the media, but these jobs are very low paid. If you work as an editor or something related to this, it's one of the lowest paid job with a high degree, so you need to be aware of this. Next on politics. Students in politics studies learn how political organization works in different states. If you really want to work in politics, it's quite difficult, as you might know. And actually, many politicians, they don't have political degree, and then they actually have some really different qualifications and experience, like business, for example. It's very common. So maybe politics, it's not a way how you become a politician. You know, you should maybe choose something else. Politics is a very interesting topic, definitely, but you also need to check what your possibilities in Germany, particularly with politics. The next one is archaeology. Here you learn about different civilizations, of course, again, history, also prehistoric societies. And Germany is not really Egypt, right? There are some old sites, there are some historical sites, but as in terms of archaeology, maybe you will find a couple of bombs from Second War, but what else? Archaeology, it's not really something for Germany. Maybe you should go to other countries to study archaeology. Also, archaeology has really bad statistic on employment. Many are unemployed because, again, Germany, it's not the perfect place for this. And even if there are some jobs for archaeologists, it's very, very few jobs, because you can probably work at the university or doing research or write books or write some articles. But that's pretty much it. Next one is social work or social science. You will learn how to work with people, to work with teenagers and also kids. During these studies, you will learn a lot about psychology, about ethics, how to behave with people, also how to behave with difficult teenagers, because in Germany, usually social workers will work with the difficult teenagers who have problems in family, so they need to be really good in psychology. Social work, it's not that bad. Actually, in Germany, many people decide to study social work if they just want to work with people. Salary is quite low, and the availability of jobs, again, less. So you can only work in some social organizations, government organizations, in authorities, in charities, with some difficult teenagers or even difficult adults. So if you are ready to be a psychologist for people with some troubles in life, you can go for it if you have really like hard skin. Rather than that, you should maybe pick sociology or something more related to the marketing, so you can study about people from different sides of it, then really work with people and to handle their problems. And the next major, it's actually sociology. It's related to the social work, where you learn also about people, but from this side you have a much bigger spectrum, so you learn about demographics, development of social structures, about just our society. Your main subjects in this studies would be political science, also economics and psychology. So it's much broader degree, but again, it's too broad to specialize yourself somewhere. So that's important. When you study, you have to pick some specialization where you're gonna go after studies, so you not end up with nothing. Usually people work in the market research or in media, but be aware that media in Germany is paid the lowest, because it doesn't produce too much added value and people just doing mishy-bashy. So if you want to really earn good money, you should pick up something with production, something with really high added value, because the media is not really the place where money made in Germany. And the last one is fine arts. I mean, if you're a creative person, why you should study even arts? You can just already do work and be creative. Like, you're just spending 3 years at university to work like what? Like the artist? So you can just start and work as an artist. You don't need to have a degree for this. To study arts is not really helpful if you want to do arts. If you want to just broaden your knowledge, if you want to learn about arts, just go in Google and take some online course. Why you should study 3 years to learn about arts? This I just don't understand. As an artist, you can work anyway without a degree. Picking the right major, it's very, very important in Germany, because statistics shows that people from humanities majors are really suffering, at least in the early years after graduation, because they can't find a job. And if we find one, it's a really short-term job for some project, they can't even find a permanent job. I'm not talking about high-paid job, because statistics shows that linguists earn 70% less than engineers in Germany. It depends what you want, because as a foreigner, you always will have it harder and more difficult than Germany as Germans. And why you will make it even more difficult for you coming to Germany and study subjects which are already low in market, which already saturated with the people who can't find a job, and they are Germans, they speak German perfectly, and as a foreigner you will always be a second choice. So don't make your life even more complicated and pick the right degree so you can really have a good future in Germany. Because Germans themselves even say that humanities are actually Brotlose degree. Brotlos, it means that you don't have a bread. So these degrees doesn't bring you bread. And I'm talking just about like have a job. You can end up even don't have a job. You can just be struggling to find a job. And if you find one, this might even don't fit in your expectation and actually not accordingly to your degree, because many humanists in Germany are working in different fields which are not related to their qualifications, their interest, and to their degree. Don't be one of this, don't be this one maybe barista who works in a Starbucks with a degree in maybe history, you know. Do the right choice, do your due diligence, do your research, and really be smart. I hope you find this video helpful if you are now choosing degree in Germany and you are thinking about humanities. Think twice, please, and think about your future. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you can see more helpful videos with information about Germany. And I will see you in the next video.